Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on running and updating data integrations in Financial Consolidation and Close Cloud. Data integration integrates data from external source systems with Financial Consolidation and Close Cloud. Data exported to flat files or Excel files from your source system is mapped to your Financial Consolidation and Close dimension structure and then imported. Data integrations are associated with locations. Each location has its own data load mappings and data load rules. Before you run data integrations for a location and period, you update the mappings and data load rules as needed. I'll run an integration to load data from this trial balance report file for the USA for July into Financial Consolidation and Close Cloud. New accounts for accounts receivable have been added to the general ledger, so I need to update the member mappings before I run the integration. From the home page, open Navigator, and in the Integration section, click Data Management. If new dimension members have been added for a location, or if member names have changed, you can update the mapping of source system member names to Financial Consolidation and Close member names. To update mapping, click Data Load Mapping. In the POV, select the location for which you want to modify mapping. Mappings can be anything from simple string replacements to powerful transformation logic. For example, if you want to consolidate accounts, you can use a like mapping with wildcards to map multiple source accounts to a single target account. I'll map all accounts that begin with the prefix 12 in the source system to the accounts receivable trade account in Financial Consolidation and Close Cloud. Next, you update the data load rule that you want to run for the location. The data load rule specifies a data file to load for a selected category and period. First, use the POV to select the period and category for which to load data. I'll load data for July actuals. Now I'll select the data file for the period. I can use the Upload button to upload the file to the inbox. If the file information is left blank, the user will be prompted to select the file at runtime. I'm ready to run the data load rule. If I want the data load to run at a later time, I can click the Schedule button. I can select from scheduling options such as daily or weekly. I want to run this integration now, so I'll click Cancel. To run a data load rule immediately, click Execute. I'll select Import from Source to import the data to the data integration staging tables. The staging tables enable me to verify that my settings and member mappings are correct before loading to Financial Consolidation and Close Cloud. I'll leave Export to Target unselected. The Export to Target option pushes the data from the staging tables to the Financial Consolidation and Close Cloud application. The status column displays the current state of the import process. Click Refresh until you see a checkmark. A checkmark means the import completed without error. I'll navigate to the workbench to view the data in the staging tables. I can verify that the mapping of source members to target members is correct. Now I'll click Export to push the data from the staging tables to Financial Consolidation and Close Cloud. The data load completed successfully. I'll open my Financial Consolidation and Close Cloud form to verify that the data was loaded. In this tutorial, you saw how to run data integrations in Financial Consolidation and Close Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.